Hey guys, what's up? It's Erika, and today we're going to talk about everything that you need to know about Florida State before you start coming here. So, for anyone that's new here, my name is Erika. I just got my bachelor's degree from Florida State University. I got my bachelor's in editing, writing, and media with a minor in communications. And I do work in public relations with a specification in sports and entertainment. Okay, so for food, I lived in Jenny Murphy, which used to be an all-girls dorm, but now it's co-ed. And if you live there, then you have to have a meal plan. So I had to have a meal plan. There's multiple levels of the meal plan. There's like unlimited, the lowest level, the medium level, all that. I started my year with the level that is above the lowest level for the first half of the semester. And then you use all your, so you get like swipes that you can use at like Chick-fil-A, Chili's when there was a Chili's on campus, Einstein Bros, Starbucks. Those swipes that you get to use there, they're like VIP swipes or something. Those are gonna go first. You're gonna use all those first. I did, you run out of them. The normal meal swipes to get into the dining halls, Swanee, the other dining hall that's by the psychology building, the one that's in the stadium, those don't run out, bro. I had the second to lowest one for the first half of the semester, and then after the first semester there, I switched to the lowest meal plan because the swipes for your meal card to get into the dining halls never run out. Like, they give you too many because you don't eat there. You're not going to eat there every day. I ate out. I went out with my friends. You can cook in the dorm. The meal plan swipes never run out. And then, like, if they do, you can add money on there to get food. Like, you can add money on there to get swipes, particularly if you add money on there to get swipes into the dining hall. So I would suggest getting the lowest plan because mine never ran out. I ate out. I cooked. I tried to make them run out. You just don't. And it's just, the meal plans cost so much money. I don't know if every dorm is required to get a meal plan, but mine it was. And that used most of my money. Like, that was given to me from the school. And, like, you don't use all of it. So I suggest getting the lowest one. I did. I don't regret it at all. I had extra money for the second semester to use on stuff that actually matters. The restaurants on campus are going to take your money. You're going to eat there all the time. I went to Chick-fil-A all the time. I used the swipes that came with my meal plan. And then I just started buying Chick-fil-A. Just because it's very convenient. The restaurants on campus are good. They're not as good as like off campus. But they're good. I went to Four Rivers. That's the first time I had Four Rivers. I had Chick-fil-A. That was the first time I had Chick-fil-A. Is when I moved on campus because there wasn't one where I lived. The Starbucks, everything's good enough. Everything is good enough. The dining hall that's by the psychology building, personally to me, has better food than Swanee, but it's just really far away. So I'd only go there when I went to my psychology class. But yeah, that's all I have to say on that. I would suggest getting the lowest one, definitely not the highest one, like the ultimate. Unless you really just have money to waste, that's the only time I would get that. And even then, I still would not. Okay, so going out in Tallahassee, my freshman year, I did not go out. I think I went out twice, and I think that was the worst mistake that I ever made in college. I'm not saying go out every day, but when I did start going out, which was like sophomore year, it really did enhance my college experience. It really made me see, like, when people are like, oh, college is the best time of your life, that's really made me see that. I feel like I wasted kind of my freshman year. I was really scared of like failing my classes and getting kicked out, which you should be scared of. But your first semester, it's really hard to get kicked out. You'd have to get like F's on everything, and like the intro classes are kind of easy. So I wouldn't say go out every day, but in Tallahassee there is something to do every single day, except for maybe Sunday. And maybe Monday, but every other day there is something to do. You just gotta go look for it. There's like pots, the strip. They have like all you can drink days where it's like $10, you can drink whatever you want. Other things, if your friends are in like, well, not if your friends, if you want to join a sorority or a fraternity, or your friends in a sorority or fraternity, sometimes they have things to go to. I suggest going to the GBMs on campus because then you meet people. They have like birthday parties or socials or game nights, if that's more of like your style. What are they called? Freshman year, me and my friend Janae and Christabel, we went to these things called like pig roasts with the, at the polo club, with the polo team, I think. Also, I would say if you are black, I would suggest going to the black parties and the white parties. Because I feel like I had great experiences at both. It's just like two different vibes. Like if you want to dance, like really dance, you go to like the black nights at the clubs. If you want to go to like a party and talk a lot, you go to the white parties at their houses, like house parties. Oh, and play like beer pong. I realize I'm really good at beer pong. I wouldn't have known that if I didn't go to the white parties, you know. Also, they're very social at the white parties. You can like talk to everybody. Everybody's having a good time. It's really great. You can talk to everybody, play beer pong, take pictures. It's like a cool vibe. And then like the black ones, it's just like, feels like home. Feels like home. You can talk to them if you want. I love like little socials. You could dance there too. They usually have really great music. Yeah. Tailgates, one thing I do say is I did not really go to tailgates for real before football games with my friends. Like they would go to Heritage, which is like the white fraternities houses, and they would have tailgates and they had like a great time. They had like bounce houses and special snow cones and things like that. I never got to experience that. I went to a tailgate once, but it was kind of like late and it was boring because some people had just gotten in trouble, so it wasn't as good as before, but it was still like a vibe. Okay, there's also a lot of stuff to do on campus. There's a circus. I went to the circus. I've never been to the circus. The only time I saw the circus is during homecoming. They have like a thing at the Donald Tucker Civic Center, and the circus performs there, but I've never been to a circus event. I never wanted to because I saw it at homecoming, but a lot of people go and a lot of people enjoy it, especially during Halloween or parents' weekends. You can also go to the SLC. I loved going to the SLC. They premiere a lot of movies there. I saw Jordan Peele's movies. Like, I saw Get Out at the SLC. It's free movies and free premieres, so I do suggest going. I also watch the movie, what do you call them? Like the, there's students on campus that make movies. They show them at the SLC too. And I really enjoyed those also. Another thing we do on campus is like Market Wednesday. I've gone to a lot of Market Wednesdays. I love Market Wednesday. It's great music. The fraternities and sororities are strolling. The clubs are out there. You can get free stuff. Sometimes there's puppies. There's like vendors selling cute things that you can't find in stores. So I would really recommend going to Market Wednesday. I loved Market Wednesday. Even though I don't recommend getting the meal plan for living on campus, I do recommend living on campus your first year. I really enjoyed living on campus and off campus. It is cheaper to live off campus, but I would say to live on campus, you go to a lot more things. Like, you're more motivated to go because you are right there. I was in like 10 different clubs. I went to everything that was happening on campus because I lived there. Once I moved off campus, I didn't want to leave my house at 7 o'clock to go to a club for 1 hour to come back home, especially because I was taking the bus. So I kind of like slowly stopped going to like all the club activities, like student club activities, like Florida Public Relations Association, things like that. I slowly stopped going because it was like not convenient for me. So I would suggest living on campus because of its convenience. Also, you meet a lot more people living on campus because there's people all around you in your dorms. That's how I met Janae. She lived upstairs. So yeah, I do suggest living on campus for 1 year. After that, you can go. You don't have to go, but you can go. It's cheaper. You can throw parties if you want. You can have people over if you want. Yeah. I don't know. Anything else you guys want to know, you can ask me down below. I don't know if there's anything else to tell you. There's a gym on campus. I didn't go a lot. There's a sauna in there, an ice pool. I loved the sauna, so I suggest going. Mom and Pops, the lemonade and sausage deal. Get it. It's delicious. What else? Go across the railroad to FAMU. I went to a football game. That was cool. The tailgates before FAMU's football game, also cool. Their homecoming events, also cool. I went to most of their homecomings, not all of them. There's great people over there. Go and enjoy them. It's like going to two schools. For one, go to Set Friday from like 12 to 3 or 1 to 3 or 11 to 1 or something like that. Go to Set Friday. Meet people from FAMU and FSU. Network with all those people. You never know. There's a lot of great people doing great things who are there at the same time as you, and everyone's trying to meet each other. I suggest just getting out there and meeting people, doing things you've never done before. Dye your hair. Go crazy. Go stupid. And if you have any questions or anything like that, leave them down below, and I'll be free to answer, and I'll be sure to answer. Subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, guys, and I hope you have a great time at Florida State. I did. I'd go back.